I am Veronica Wasek with 5-Minute Bookkeeping, and in this video, I'm talking to all of my YouTube viewers, whether you're a Shopify seller, small business owner, or virtual bookkeeper, and I'm going to show you how to add an account in the new QuickBooks Online chart of accounts. Keep in mind that you may not have this functionality yet. Usually QuickBooks Online will roll out their changes over time, so you may see it in your QuickBooks Online. It may be something that you've seen for quite a while already in your QuickBooks, or you may not see it yet, but rest assured that at some point you will see this new way of adding accounts into the chart of accounts. In the previous chart of accounts in QuickBooks Online, when adding an account, you would need to choose from an account type. And the account type determined how the account behaved in the report. So it would just determine whether it showed up under the balance sheet or the profit and loss. For example, if I wanted to add a bank account, then I would choose bank. Then you would choose from the detail type. Let's say that I was adding a checking account. Then you would name the account. You have the option of adding a description. And then if the account was a sub-account of a parent account, you would have to click on the box and select from the list to enter the parent account. And then you have the option of adding opening balances into your QuickBooks, which I don't recommend doing from the chart of accounts. And then you would save and close. To add an account in the new chart of accounts in QuickBooks Online, click New. And now you have the option of selecting from what I would call these account buckets, whether it's income, expenses, banks, assets, credit cards, liabilities, and equity. Let's say that we wanted to add an expense account. We'll choose expenses. And now you have a choice of adding this expense account under cost of goods sold or expenses. Let's say that I wanted to add an account under expenses, but I also want to make it a sub-account of advertising, meaning that I want my account to live under advertising because I want to add a Google advertising account to my chart of accounts, similarly to how Facebook advertising was added. I'll go ahead and choose advertising. So notice now that this is basically allowing me to set up a sub-account. I selected advertising. Next, you have the tax form section. Choose from the down arrow. Notice that it defaulted to other miscellaneous service cost. So if you really don't know what the tax form section is, and I really wouldn't expect hardly anybody to know that unless you're a tax professional, you can let it default to that. It's really not going to mess up anything because this is really more for a tax preparer to use these categories, and I would expect them to review the categories before they did anything with them. But I see that I do have an option for advertising and promotional, so I'll go ahead and select that. I'll go ahead and add the account name. Then I have the option to add a description if I want to. I won't. And we have this very useful new feature. It's called the New Account Preview. What this does is it'll show you what the account category will look like in the report where it'll show up. So for example, we know that because this is an expense, it'll show up in the profit and loss report, under expenses, and then under advertising. And here's our new account. We'll go ahead and click Save. Now that you know how to add accounts to the new QuickBooks Online chart of accounts, let me know what you think. So, do you like the new format that they came up with, or do you want the old format? I, for one, prefer the old format. So let me know in the comments what you think. I'm Veronica Wasek with 5-Minute Bookkeeping. If this content is helping you, then subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and give me a thumbs up. Are you ready to work with a trusted and reliable Shopify bookkeeping pro? Then look in the description below to learn more about my services. And also check the description for all of my free resources, including the link to join my Facebook community. I'll see you next time.